everyone. My name is Shilpa Subramanian, and I'm a product manager on the Microsoft Edge team. And we're on a mission to make Microsoft Edge the best browser for business. Today, I'm here to talk to you about Internet Explorer mode, or IE mode, and to give you a glimpse of what we're working on to make that seamless single browser experience for all your modern and legacy needs even better. We'll start out by framing the IE mode journey and what we've learned from listening to your feedback thus far, and then where we are currently and our vision for IE mode, what our immediate focus is, and then a design walkthrough of cloud-based site list management through the M365 Admin Center. With IE mode on Microsoft Edge, the perfect one browser for all your browsing in the enterprise is now possible. Your users never have to worry about switching from their modern browser to access a legacy application that they previously needed IE for. This experience is seamless for your users. And from a management perspective, your journey looks something like this. You identify a legacy site, you create and manage site lists, and then you modernize legacy applications. This experience is represented sequentially, but in reality, it is circular. You identify your site, you add them to your list, and when you're ready to modernize or you have modernized already, you take them off of the site list. Rinse and repeat. Most of our customers are in a steady hold phase with the site list. They have a site list and they have to manage updates to it. Modernizing legacy applications is the North Star, and that's where you want to end up. But we understand that that kind of transformation takes time, and we are here to help you get there with Microsoft Edge. In customer conversations focusing on that phase of managing site lists, we've heard that more than 60% of customers rely on third-party workflow management software, and less than 10% of customers have automation built to manage those site lists. This presents an opportunity to make the site list management part of your journey a lot easier, and one less thing for you to worry about. So, where are we today, and where are we going? On the x-axis, you'll see the progression from where we are with on-prem management to where we want to be, in the cloud. The future of IE mode is cloud-based site list management. Think of the transitional section as a bridge to make that journey easier as you prepare to move to the cloud. On the y-axis, you'll see the phases of your journey that we just talked about. In the on-prem world, the site list is hosted on-prem, and all the tools you need to discover legacy sites and manage site lists are also on-prem. When we move to cloud-based site list management, you can host your site list in the cloud and manage it through the M365 Admin Center. Let's start with the discovery of legacy sites. Today, you have the Site Discovery Toolkit on-prem. In the transitional phase, we're building expert user feedback. This is the ability from within the Microsoft Edge browser for your users to let you know that they have sites that require IE11 compatibility and that they need to be added to the site list. When we move to the cloud, this expert user feedback will be integrated with an approval workflow. At this point, you'll not need to rely on any third-party workflow management software. We'll also build in automated site detection. For instance, think of this as having machine learning models in your tenant or your organization to help identify sites that need IE mode. Moving on to managing site lists. Today you have the standalone enterprise site list manager on-prem. In the transitional phase, we'll have a local site list manager available through the browser, through Edge Compat. This lets you create, edit, and export your site list. We've heard your feedback on the current tool, especially around the speed of updates and communication. And this version of the site list manager in the browser will have frequent updates accompanied by release notes as we make improvements to the IE mode site list. When we move to cloud-based list management, you'll be able to do all of this and more, like setting up multiple site lists for validation through the M365 Admin Center. And here's what comes to you first to simplify your IE mode journey: hosting the site list in the cloud. Right now, most of you are hosting the site list on an on-prem server or a file share. In the future, you can host the site list in a Microsoft-managed, secure, GDPR-compliant cloud location. And then you'll be able to manage that site list with an experience in the M365 Admin Center. One of the first experiences for Microsoft Edge in the M365 Admin Center will be site list management. This enables us to create rich automation to tie together everything that you need, starting from the discovery of legacy sites to managing them. In addition to the rich user experience, you'll have a single place for all your site list needs, backed by RBAC controls, easy updates to the site list in the cloud, retaining version history, and so much more. Next, we'll look at a design walkthrough, showing you a sneak peek of what this experience will look like in the M365 Admin Center. We'll start at the M365 Admin Center homepage. This should be familiar territory to a lot of you. On the left nav, you can go to settings, as you usually do, to manage your app preferences, and click through that. And now you see there's been a new row added for site list. You click on that, and you see a flyout panel on your right showing you the site list that you have, with its name, a short description, and when it was last updated. Let's click on that site list. Now you see a full page experience within the M365 Admin Center. The details on this should be familiar to all of you. These are the contents of your XML for your site list. The site address, the opens in, allow redirect, compatibility mode. And then we've added a couple of columns for the cloud basis management, owner, and last edited. On top, you'll see options to add a site, import list, and export list. So now let's walk through a few of those functionalities within Admin Center. So click on add a site, for example. You click on that and a flyout pops up. You now have the option to add in all the details for your site, the site address, opens in, the compatibility mode, allow redirect, and then you can add an owner and leave a comment on why you're adding this to the list. Then you click on add, and you have confirmation that your site is added to the site list. Moving on, let's see how to import a site list and what that experience looks like. You click on import list at the very top. So now you're bringing in something from your local machine. Let's click on browse, and your file explorer opens up and allows you to choose the file you need. I'm going to pick the 2020 list.xml and click on open and upload. And now you have confirmation, basically a review of all the sites that have been found and that are going to get added. So now there's 7 sites and you can review or edit them if you need to. If not, you can just move forward and add them. Now 7 sites have been added to your production site list. Let's see what editing a site looks like. So I want to edit here Microsoft.com. It's been set to open in IE11, and I want to have it open in Microsoft Edge going forward. So I click on that row, and now I see that there is a new button that's popped up between Add a Site and Import List to edit this site entry. I can either click on that or click on the edit link in the flyout panel that just opened up as well. So I'll click on that edit. And then you can edit the details by going down to Opens In, clicking on the dropdown, and selecting Microsoft Edge. Once I've done that, I'm going to hit Save. And now the site has been updated. Now let's look at viewing comments. This has been a feature that a lot of you were super excited about, knowing that we could have an auditing trail for compliance. So let's go back to the same example of Microsoft.com. Take a look at the flyout panel. You'll see on the bottom section beneath edit, there is the latest comment, and there's also a view history button. You click on view history, and then you can see all of the past updates that were made to that entry. You'll see details for which user made that change, when did they make that change, and what comments they left as they changed it. There you go. Now let's look at exporting a site list. This is fairly straightforward. You click on the export list right at the top, and you'll see a message that says to allow extra time if you're exporting longer site lists. And then you click on export, and then you'll see that the file is starting to download. And that's it. That was a quick walkthrough of the design we have for site list management in the M365 Admin Center. Before we wrap up, if you haven't done so already, enable IE mode today. aka.ms IE mode on Edge is your best friend for all the details you need on how to do this. And stay tuned for updates on cloud-based site list management. Thank you so much for your time today, and thank you for watching this video.